Welcome to Degree Fitness's Coach Box Chat. Today we have Coach MJ with us, and she is going to be talking about our wellness coaching program. So, MJ, first question is, who is this program designed for?
We've designed it basically for people 55 and over, but not limiting that. A lot of times people have things like arthritis, fibromyalgia, or any other movements that think that limit our movement day to day. So we want to give you a place that you can move safely and efficiently and build strength at the same time and not feel threatened by heavy weights and I have to do it this way, but organizing it to make it work for you where you're at right now.
Yeah, no, that's great. So what's the main focus of the program if somebody were to get started? What's your main focus? Is it functional fitness, strength?
I like to look at it as GPP, which is general physical preparedness. So that's working on our movements that we use in everyday life, our mobility, our balance, our flexibility, and adapting things to make it work for how we do it. For example, your push-up. Larissa has an awesome push-up. She can get there from her toes, and it's amazing. She does such a great job. Mm-hmm. But the majority of people can't do it, which is fine. We can go from our knees if we still want to go from the floor, or we take a box and we go to a height that works. Some people, it doesn't work for their wrists, so then we would take a barbell to the rig, and then it just adjusts our wrist position, and we can slowly build the strength and lower down to wherever we get comfortable to.
I think that's nice about your program, that you don't have to be at a certain fitness level, but you can adapt any movement to fit the client.
Yes, and if it doesn't work,
we
find another one.
Right.
So we have one client who could not do a push-up, so we went to a floor press, so we just went on the ground with the dumbbells and did the same basic movement, working the same muscles, but adjusting it to make it work for her, and she got a great workout.
What if someone can't do a range of motions?
That's kind of what we just talked about. You kind of did just touch on that.
But say someone comes in and they've had a knee replacement or something to do with their knees, waiting for a knee replacement, they can't squat, deadlifting doesn't feel good. What would you sub in replacement of that? They're still working those legs but able to do a movement.
Or your things like anything that deals with squatting or anything, we would sit. We'd find a movement that would work for you and still work the same movements. It's hard to say what to do exactly because it's going to depend on your range of motion, how easy you can get up and down off the ground. But that's why it's important to come in beforehand and have a chat with a coach or somebody so that we can be prepared for whatever your limitations are. And have an alternative for you. So if we're squatting, majority of our people squat to a bench, so we would just adjust the height again to what you're able to do. Or if you can't squat, we can do a glute bridge, or we'll just find something to keep you moving, going, and build the strength on to be able to eventually get to them. And if you never get to them, it doesn't matter, we're gonna keep you moving.
I think what's nice too about here is that we work with healthcare professionals to, if there are certain limitations, we can work with the chiropractor, physiotherapist, or whoever, massage therapist, to
with the client's permission,
we
would get in contact and figure out what way to help you move the best to keep you going.
Right, exactly. So what can somebody gain from joining this program?
Feeling confident in the body that you have now. We always look back at, I used to be able to do this, or before I had kids, or at this stage, but life happens. Work-related injuries, or wear and tear on our bodies, arthritis, unknown things that come up are going to change the way we move and feel mentally about ourselves too. So we want to build confidence, as well as building body strength, working on areas to keep us moving.
Yeah.
I just have a little story for two wonderful mothers, my mother-in-law and my mother. They are been awesome examples throughout our life of keeping moving. They worked hard, they did everything. They both dealt with arthritis. My mom kept moving, kept going. She's still with us, and she makes sure she walks every day. She makes sure she does her stretches and her exercises and keeps moving. She still has her arthritis. It's still difficult some days, but she keeps moving and she's able to do it. My mother-in-law slowly slowed down in everything that she did, and slowly, eventually it was really hard to do everything. So she was comfortable sitting in her chair doing the minimal.
Yeah.
But her quality of life, her mom's quality of life, were two different stories.
Right. Because one is moving all the time, and the other one is stationary all the time.
Yeah.
So your body adapts to what you're allowing it to do.
And that goes for all ages and body types. The less we do, the less we want to do. The more we do, our body wants to keep moving and keep going. So
you have to kind of think of it like the Tin Man.
Yeah.
Those things don't keep oiled, so moving.
Yeah.
That they tend to seize up, and you can't do the things
that
you're not able to do.
Yeah.
So keeping everything moving and mobile is going to aid you in moving forward and living a more mobile and happy life than if you were just like, oh, I can't do this. It's too much pain, too much work, and you're just sad.
And some days are going to be better than others, and some days it's just about getting in and moving and being with the group.
Right.
So your workout may not have been the toughest, that might not have been your best, but mentally you were out of the house, you were moving, you got out, you did stuff. So that sometimes is the bigger win than having the toughest exercise program that you have.
Exactly. Yeah. Perfect. Well, thank you very much for that.
Thank you.
And your wellness program starts in September.
September 12th, from 9:30 to 10:30. For 4 weeks, we run it as a 4-week program.
Mm-hmm.
And we'd love to hear from you.
So yeah, we'll update everybody on the Degree Fitness page and just let you know when that is coming up, and then the next 4 weeks after that, and the next 4 weeks after that. Well, thanks again, MJ, for taking the time to chat with us about the program.
You're welcome.